It's very difficult to support a business exclusively on lobster.
When you've got a single product being responsible for that much money, you know, it makes you blank.
So we are in Booth Bay Harbor, which is where our Maine Department of Marine Resources science is based.
Up until the 1990s, the fishing industry in Maine remained steady with about 20 million pounds of lobster a year. Since then, the industry saw an explosive increase.
So the last 5 or 6 years, we've been over 100 million.
This explosion is just, it's blown everybody's minds. We've been trying to unpack that, trying to unravel the mechanisms behind that. A lot of it has to do with the depletion of their predators. But climate change, too, has really played an important role.
Temperature drives the life stages of lobster, life cycle through the year, when they molt and when they have their eggs and development as larvae.
We saw these eastern areas just become increasingly populated by juveniles, and then shortly thereafter, the fishery just took off. And the big question for Maine is how long it's going to last. Maine harvests about 80% of the U.S. harvest. Of course, beyond just that landed value, there are all the industries that depend on that, you know, boat builders and trap builders and rope makers. When you've got a single product being responsible for that much money, you know, it makes you blank. Yeah, when you think of what could happen if it disappears. Yeah.
Where are we going?
Narragansett.
What for?
Help some crab and lobster fishermen.
Over the past few decades, Maine has experienced record-high lobster landings, while the fishery in southern New England has seen a substantial decline, where lobsters may have moved to colder or deeper waters.
As a result of the decline in the resource, the actual industry or the fleet that's been harvesting lobsters has also shrunk in Rhode Island. So we have fewer fishermen who are actually targeting lobster. Now, those who are still harvesting lobster are doing so very successfully, but it's very difficult to support a business exclusively on lobster.
To compensate for the lack of lobster, fishermen are having to adopt new fishing techniques, and many are diversifying their catch with species such as the Jonah crab.
I fish less traps now. It's not the same as it was back in the heyday. When lobster and slow, you catch crabs. The crabbing has picked up and it's become more popular and valuable.
So Jonah crab, the abundance of Jonah crab, has increased exponentially over the past decade or so. So this is a fishery that basically didn't exist 10 years ago. It now is in the top 10 for value in both Massachusetts and Rhode Island. And so Jonah crab has really begun to help fishing businesses, particularly those that were traditionally focused on lobster, diversify. They're able to use and harvest these two species kind of in tandem to help support their fishing businesses. And of course, then the shoreside facilities actually support that as well.
My name's David Spencer. I'm an offshore lobsterman from Newport here. I don't go fishing myself anymore. I just manage the boat and I manage the Newport Lobster Shack. 12, 15 years ago, the lobster population in southern New England did decline. And we saw an emergence of the Jonah crab population. And it wasn't just a little bit. I mean, it really came on hard. And interestingly enough, and this almost never happens, the market expanded at the same time. So we had processors that were looking for the product as the product became more available. So it was really one of the things that enabled the Southern New England lobster fleet at that time to stay vibrant and whole.
After talking with David and touring his humble lobster shack, he surprised us with a generous seafood feast.
Oh, jeez. Thank you.
Holy moly!
Again, when it's warm, it doesn't usually work, but it is working, so...
is that part of the technique, always look away or before it's about to?
Yeah.
So you don't get, oh, yeah, there's the can't really.
That's a good one.
I know you guys just heard it, but I'm going to say it again.
Gotta catch that.
That's right. Yeah, I think I'm on Team Jonah Crab.
That sounded way too fake. We're done. We're not doing it.
We just had a phenomenal meal with a slowly growing delicacy known as the Jonah Crab. And I can say for certain it is delicious. And I think Jonah Crab is actually better than lobster. So I really hope to see this on more menus throughout the state.
Fishing is always evolving. Fishermen have always had to shift their fishing practices to how the ecosystem is changing.
I personally think that the stock of lobster is good because of the increase in regulation, less traps in the water. There are more breeding lobsters.
V-notch, can't keep
it. Oh yeah?
During the 1950s and 1970s, fishermen started V-notching themselves. They said, this is an egger. I want to protect this lobster in the future. And that V-notch shows that it is a breeder. And they're otherwise legal sized lobsters, but it protects them from harvest.
One of the challenges going forward for the industry is going to be able to find ways to maintain their resilience and their ability to diversify their business in the face of a more and more constraining regulatory environment.
Got another short one here. Just toss it.
Yep, okay, throw it right over.
In 2004, a group of fishermen established the Commercial Fisheries Research Foundation to bridge a direct working relationship with scientists.
Science seemed to be lagging behind all the time. Our feeling was work collaboratively with academia and scientists and the industry and go out and try and minimize these uncertainties.
Science should be used in everyday life. The only way that us as people and us as fishermen are going to understand what to do correctly moving forward is to have that information readily available. It is giving us knowledge that we can use going forward to make correct decisions both on the boat and off the boat.